So do we have any questions? Yesterday session. Sorry.
Can we go to the application?
Okay.
Going through that, I got some basic question. Maybe this is a very basic question.
Mm-hmm.
I just not able to understand that the HTTP connectors, how to use that, I got it.
Mm-hmm.
But where exactly, I mean, say for example, in Java, any application, when we get the requirement, I know like how to develop it and UI page and from user side, but here somewhat I'm missing something where we are using HTTP connectors and some flow I'm missing.
Okay. Okay, so generally how it will happen, I will explain a scenario. Suppose there is a GUI, okay. GUI already there. Think like this. There is a Java portal. Okay.
Okay.
There is a Java portal. That portal is exclusively for creating some opportunities.
Okay.
Creating some opportunities means creating some business. Okay. So our middleware is there. Nothing but our mail ESP. Okay. That is our middleware. So then here some target system. So target system is like nothing but some CRM application. CRM app is nothing but some Salesforce or else some like whatever it is, Salesforce or else some Hadoop.
Okay.
Whatever it is. So now where we are? We are in middleware. Okay.
Okay.
We are in middleware. So this is a Java portal. So there is some interface. Right. So whatever you told, right? You only creating the GUI, right? Okay, no?
Yes.
So you enter some data, there is an interface, you enter some data, whenever you hit the submit button, so according to your logic, it will go to the your database or else it will go somewhere else, it will pick the data, it will show on your GUI accordingly. Okay, no?
Yes.
That is normal Java web applications, right? So but here, so it's nothing but web service. So first, your portal, whenever a user will enter, suppose here for creating a opportunities, so there is a some Java page is there, some portal is there, okay. User will enter the data, okay. So whenever user will enter data after hitting the submit button, so the request come to the middleware with some fields, so opportunity name, then opportunity amount, like there's some fields are coming, so how much quantity you want, suppose he is trying to buy some Cisco product, right? So that Cisco product information, whatever you filled in the GUI, so that information will come to the middleware. Okay, so what we need to do, so as a middleware guys, we need to do some operation on that. So what operation it is exactly? So our final target is what? So we need to insert this opportunity into the CRM application. Okay, or else some Hadoop, or else we need to hit some database. Think like this. Whatever the target system it is. This is a target system. So this is a source system. So we are in the middleware people. So this guy was expecting some Salesforce object, right? He is sending as a Java object. Okay. As a middleware guy, we need to take that input. Then we need to convert how this guy was expecting. So that format we have to convert it. Understood. So we have to convert into, then we have to insert the opportunity into the CRM application or else Hadoop system or else whatever the Oracle database MySQL is, we'll insert it. Once insert successfully, it will return some message. So means like if it is a opportunity, once you insert it, then we'll get some unique ID, right? Opportunity ID will get it. So that ID we have to send back to the source who you are requesting. We should know, we should tell them, right? So successfully opportunity got created, then our sales AM will contact soon. That type of message we have to send back, right? And
yes.
it's a synchronous kind of thing, right? So once you hit the request, you have to send the response. You are getting.
Okay.
So now
yes.
We are in the middleware people, so we'll take care of that. Whatever, whoever the client, not only Java portal, so whatever it is. So that's a beauty of this web services actually. Not only Java, so there is a .NET, there is a something like C, CPP, whatever the application it is, whatever the client it is. We'll take the request, we'll convert that format what this guy was expecting. So we'll convert into that format, so we'll send it, we'll get back the response, and we'll send back the that response to the whoever requesting. Understood?
Okay. Yes, yes.
Now tell me your question.
This like concept that like I got it, but whenever we are going for the application side,
okay.
So example here exactly
yeah.
The connectors for which and what I
yes.
need,
you have a
I got
question.
it.
Yeah, yes,
here exactly HTTP connector we are starting with and set payload. This I'm not getting.
So
like,
your question is why here HTTP you use, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so
yes.
Good. See here, so here we are exposing a service actually. So we are exposing a service. So this guy was trying to use our REST call. So we are exposing a REST service. So I told about two services, SOAP and REST, right?
Yes.
Understood. We are exposing one endpoint, so one URL we are trying to expose. This guy was, he was trying to use that URL, he will send the information. So how will interact with us? He should need some information, right?
Yes.
Understood. He should need some endpoint, he should need some URL. So I told you about REST call, right? So REST is always talking about some URL. If it is a SOAP,
yes.
So there is a WSDL file is there. That is a contract between this guy and us. Understood. If it is a REST call, it's a URL based. So we need to share some URL. That URL he will use. He is trying to connect us. Understood.
Okay.
Even as a middleware guy, so we need to connect to the some third party. I mean some target system. How will connect?
Yes.
We need some URL. Understood. We need some URL, or else we need some database credentials for connecting that guy, for connecting some target system. Understood. If you want to connect Salesforce, so we need some URL, right? That Salesforce URL, that production URL you need. So then production URL as well as some client ID, secret ID to connect to the Salesforce system. So there is a security, right? So there is some OAuth authentication. So we need to achieve that authentication using that client ID, secret ID, or some URL. So everything we have to enter into the connector, Salesforce connector and the middleware. So whenever you configure it, that time you can able to connect. So like here also, so we need to give some URL to connecting the client, right? So that's why here we need some HTTP, some inbound connector. Not, I'm not talking about HTTP only. So many inbound connectors are there for this requirement. For this requirement, so we need HTTP connector. So whenever you use HTTP connector, so we'll get some URL, right? So if you see here, so there is a remote URL. Now we are in localhost. In future, this localhost it won't work, right? Some remote address we should give. Client is somewhere else, right? He is sitting some years or else somewhere else, right? We need to give some public address, public domain address. Understood? Public IP with domain you have to give it, right? From anywhere else he can able to connect it like that. So if you share that, HTTP, HTTP, localhost, H014, then base path. This URL you have to share it. So then he is trying to reach you. So using that URL. Understood. Why HTTP only we are using? So you know that about browser will always talking about HTTP only. This is a protocol actually. HTTP is nothing but a protocol. So using that protocol, so we'll communicate it actually. A browser will know this protocol only. If you see anything, if you see any URL, it's always talking about HTTP. HTTP and HTTPS. So HTTPS is a secure protocol. HTTP is a protocol. In future also, once you done the application, your URL should be secure. Then you will convert into, we'll add the tests actually. For security reasons, if you see any bank website, it will start with HTTPS, right? There is a security authentication, security. Understood. So we need some URL for connecting client. I mean, client want to connect to middleware. We need to expose some URL. We need to give some endpoint. We implement a service. This is nothing but a service. We implement a service. How this service will call by client. So we need some information to give it to him. So that information in HTTP connector will keep it actually. So this is one requirement. So that's what actually based on requirement will change the endpoint, will change the inbound connector. This is one scenario. So here user will talk to us. So for that we need give some URL. So if you want to give the, if you want to and expose some endpoint, we should use an HTTP connector. You are clear?
Yes. So here we are talking with one client. Say for example we are in middle. So we are talking with the client as well as say for example here Java portal and CRM application, anything else. So this URL we are giving to both of them.
Yes. No. We are giving to client who are consuming us.
Okay.
But here we are the clients. We are consuming to third party. Here we are exposing this guy was using. Understood. Here two terminologies. One is consuming means client. So another one is exposing means exposing a service. Here we exposing a service. This guy was trying to use. He is trying to hit us. Right. In this case, we are the exposer. According to this particular application, we are the exposer, he is trying to consume it. Understood. But here might be here one service is there. Now here in this application we are using some connector to connect to the third party application. Think like this, there is no connector, then he just exposes service, right? Now that time what happened, we are acting as a client again.
Okay.
Understood. So he is exposed. So we are the consumers. Now in this case also sometimes we need to consume that guy. Depend on the requirement actually. Either we'll access a consumer or else either access a exposer.
Okay.
You are
so
clear?
We play both.
Yes.
Yes.
Based on requirement, either we'll access a consumer, either we'll access a exposer.
Okay.
But that according to this application, so we are exposing an endpoint. So we are giving a service. So then he is trying to use our service. So based on service, he will use that URL. He will hit us. We'll take that input from him. So then we are hitting to the third party.
Okay.
You are clear, right? So in this case, we are using a HTTP connector because we are acts as an exposer here. So think like that. There is one more scenario I will explain. So why not only HTTP connector based on requirement our inbound connector will change actually. Okay, another scenario is think like this. We are trying to create some order. So I'm using some Amazon. I'm trying to order some products. Okay, Here requirement is, here his requirement is, whenever you order the requirements, so we'll frame that as XML, then we'll head to some Hadoop machine. Okay, see this requirement. So Amazon requirement is, so once you order the items, okay, suppose I order some 10 items. So internally what happened, they implement some JSON format or else XML format, each item they'll frame it actually. Some XML they create it, understood? Once you order the items, so they will create internally, each item is nothing but inside one sub element under XML. Understood? XML is nothing but a combination of root element, sub element kind of thing, right? You are clear?
Yes.
So once you create the order, so internally it will create each item is nothing but some subroot element, understood? So finally he'll create one XML, understood? Here his requirement is, so we need to compress that XML, we need to store into Hadoop for future purpose. His requirement is like that. You are clear?
Yes. So as of now, let's assume without ESP means just issue storing in database, correct?
Without?
Say for example here, whatever we are ordering the items without an ESP, say for example it was storing in database, correct? Whatever, I am just talking about without ESP and anything, any requirement. It will be in database, right?
Yeah.
So now when coming into Mule or any ESP, then we need to fetch that data and we are going to give some other third party, correct?
Yes, see, that's what, think like there, some legacy system is there. Once you click the create the order, that order directly storing into some database like Oracle or MySQL, something like that. So legacy system. So we are going to introduce some ESB in this case. Okay. So what we are doing, so once you will create the XML internally, then we need to call that ESB. We need to call that XML using our middleware, whatever the ESB it is, either MuleSoft or else Oracle Fusion ESB, whatever it is. So we need to fetch this XML. Okay. So we need to store into Hadoop system. We need to convert it as some tar file or else GIF file, right? We need to store into Hadoop system. That is their requirement. So in this case, we need to use some other connector. I'm this scenario why I'm explaining, I'm talking about this inbound connector.
Okay.
So for calling this, we need to call this, right? So once you create the order, that XML they will generate, they will place into some folder, right? Some secure folder, they will keep it, XML, right? So from according to date wise, according to day wise, they will create some name also, right? So what we need to do as a middleware guy, so we have to use some other inbound connector. There is nothing but FTP, file transfer protocol. So in place of HTTP, we need to use FTP.
Okay.
Understood. So we have to use FTP. The functionality of FTP is we have to give path actually. Okay. So that will check it actually. In that folder, that particular item is there or not. Once it will there, it will pick it actually.
Okay.
So we need to set some poll also. Every 2 minutes we have to fetch. Every day you have to fetch, every some refresh time you can keep it accordingly. That will keep on checking if that XML is available, it will pick it up, then it will give it to the next in the flow. That is the first component in our flow, right? It will go to the next message processor, whatever you want to do, logic, some tarring or else some do modification of the XML. Once you convert into some GIF format, then we'll insert into the Hadoop. So this FTP is keep on searching into the Amazon folder. So then it will check it. So if there, then it will pick it up. Then it will convert into some whatever the expected format. So then it will convert into the middleware. Then it will insert to the Hadoop.
Okay.
So in this requirement, you have to use FTP connector. FTP or else SFTP, secured FTP.
Okay, these are all comes under inbound.
Yes, exactly. So not only HTTP connector, based on requirement, we'll use FTP connector. Sometimes, suppose another scenario. You are clear? Second scenario, right?
Yes, yes.
So another scenario. So suppose already some message stored in some queue. Okay. So already message there in the queue. Queue means queuing mechanism. So there is some third parties or RabbitMQ, ActiveMQ. So there is a queuing mechanism is there. So that message is already in queue. Okay, now. So that time what we need to do from middleware. So there is a AMQP connector. So we need to subscribe that queue actually. So the AMQP connector functionality is, it is again inbound actually. You are clear? So this AMQP connector, it will keep on checking the message is available or not in the queue. If the message is available, then it will fetch it. Message is nothing but payload. So if the payload is there, it will fetch it accordingly whatever you want to do in the middleware. So then we'll do in the middleware. Then we'll hit to some third party. Whoever want that message, then we'll hit to them.
Okay.
You're clear. So why queuing mechanisms here? Previously, you were creating only one opportunity at a time. Think like user want to create 1,000 opportunities at a time. So our server won't respond at a time 1,000 opportunities, right? Understood. So that's why we'll insert into the queue. So from the queue, we'll fetch one by one. We'll insert into the Salesforce. We'll get back the response, we'll share it accordingly. Understood? So that time what happened, we need to use some inbound connector as AMQP. Some connectors are there, we'll use that, we'll subscribe the queue. So then once you subscribe, so whatever, if the message is available, automatically that pick it up, then it will do some middleware operation, whatever you want, according to our business requirement. So then it will hit to the third party. So means in this, so based on our requirement, our inbound connector will change.
Okay.
So you are clear? Still you have a question?
I'm clear. Just is there any possibility to show me this one scenario programmatically?
Yeah. In future anyway will come now. These are all will come. XML format will come, then queuing mechanism will come. Every scenario will come. This is the basic only we started.
Okay. Sure. Thank you.
Okay. So did you start implementing?
No, the thing is I have downloaded Anypoint Studio. When I'm running that file application that it is giving some error.
What error it is? Did you install Java first?
Yeah, I have Java 7 in my laptop.
Then fine. So what operating system are you using? Either 32-bit or 64-bit?
It's 64-bit.
Then did you download 64-bit only in Anypoint Studio?
Yeah, I have downloaded the 64, but it is showing some exit code. Maybe
Can you copy the error, then I will tell you what was the issue.
Yeah, I'll just move it. I'm just copying it.
Yeah. Otherwise, you can share your mission.
That would be better.
Yeah. I will give control to you. You can share your mission.
Can you tell me how to share the screen here?
I'm giving request, just accept it.
Okay.
Did you get it?
Yes.
Share a mission.
I think you are able to see the screen.
Yeah.
Okay. open it. Yeah, like this.
Click OK. It's not coming then.
No,
This is,
it's
I think
not.
it's a problem with 32, 64 bit related actually. See, top of that OS is Windows 32. Just you downloaded 32 bit, I guess. Click OK.
Then it will exist, then nothing will come.
Your
I see
operating
something
system
new.
is 64 only, right?
Yes.
You downloaded 30 bit actually, 32 bit I guess. That is a problem.
Oh, one second. Like this only, like I have clicked on 64 bit only, but how come it is downloaded 32 bit? I'm not sure. Okay, maybe I'll get it from Srikanth at least, because this is taking much time to download.
So this one you downloaded or else you downloaded,
No,
right?
I have
Okay.
downloaded. Yes, I have downloaded, because yesterday Srikanth forgot to bring that. So I tried myself and downloaded, and later on when I clicked this, I was seeing this error code. I didn't click it either. It is for 32 bit or 64 bit. It will take very much time to download.
So
I'll try to
can I
get
go
it.
to C drive?
Yeah, sure.
Program files,
Okay.
Java, open JDK 1.8. That's fine. Java is the okay, just check it. So I suspect that is a problem actually.
So that is for 32 bit one.
It won't support actually. You should download according to your operating system.
I have clicked on 64 bit only. How come it is?
So what was the options it was asking? So Windows or Linux, that type of option also it was asking, right?
Yeah, Windows, Linux, and
Windows
Mac.
then.
I have Windows and then in there against two options, 64 bit and 32 bit, like any software we are installing.
Okay,
So
fine.
64 bit. Okay, now I'll try to get that.
Can you open your command prompt?
Sure.
Did you set the class path and all for Java?
Yeah, I have set it on. I want them to type
Type Java C. And it will set the class path also.
Sorry?
You didn't set the class path also. Type Java. This is fine actually. So we need no need to set the class path also. That is not the problem. So that is any points today is the problem.
So before going to this any points today, we need to set class all class types in here.
No, not required actually, because what happened, so whenever you will open the AnyPoint Studio, internally we'll set the JRAs and all actually. That is not a problem.
Okay. Then the problem with download only, I guess, because it was taking long time, and also in the middle of that it has stopped, and again I have resumed it. So maybe might be the problem is there only.
Okay, just check it. So once not done, let's see. We'll see tomorrow again. What was the issue? Might be there is the issue. It will fix, then fine.
Okay.
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 Okay. So maybe already 7:10. Okay. So we'll discuss about MMC. So then how we'll deploy this. So this is a one way of deployment actually. So we'll right click on this, we'll deploy directly run as Mule application. Okay now. So in the production in other environments, how it will happen. So we'll discuss that part. So with this remaining time, whenever we'll develop it, that time only we'll use directly we'll deploy like this actually. Suppose you want to deploy some other environment, dev environment or else some test or else production environment. So how we'll deploy this application? So we need to zip it actually. So we need to zip this file. So there is an export option is there, export.
Okay.
So under that mule there is an option called AnyPoint Studio Project to Mule Deployable Archive. So we need to zip this content. So this I'm just zip this content.
Fine.
So we'll get some zipped format actually. Okay. So once you click, so that will come here. So this is the zipped content. It will come here. Okay. Now means what? Whatever you've done in your application, we are zipping. So in Java, we'll create a var file, right?
Yes.
In Java, we'll create a var file. We'll deploy it to Tomcat. We'll install Tomcat in local. Then we'll deploy under web apps folder is there, no?
Yes.
You're aware, right? So in web apps folder, we'll copy that var file into web apps. Then we'll start the Tomcat. Then accordingly, we'll hit the requirement, hit the request, right?
Yes.
Okay. Similarly, here also, first we have to create that. So this GIF format. Okay, now so deployable archival file we have to export it. Okay, so then what we need to do, so there is a MMC is the Mule Management Console. So runtime server
okay.
We have to install in a, I mean I'm talking about local actually, so wherever you are, so
okay.
You are in test environment or else you are production environment, we have to install that actually. So for that, so we need to download so Mule Management Runtime Server, MMC server, you have to download it actually. So I already downloaded, so that is under where under surface where it is, yeah, see this is the one actually. So MMC distribution Mule console bundle I downloaded already. So here, so we have to start, shutdown, startup options are there. Once you download it, so just search for Mule Management Console. Okay, so here there is a link we'll get, just download accordingly. You are getting what was the purpose of this. So now we are downloading AnyPoint Studio itself, right? You are clear?
Yes.
So here if you say there is no server we added internally. So internally what happened? There is a internally one Jetty server is there, like Tomcat. You are clear? So it will deploy into the Jetty server. That plugin no need to add. So by default that AnyPoint Studio have. So whenever you are
Okay.
trying to deploy like this, run as mail application internally, that will deploy under Jetty server, JETTY. So that Jetty server is there. So that will deploy under Jetty server. Accordingly, it will work. But if you see any Eclipse kind of thing, we need to add that plugin. Suppose that Tomcat plugin or else WebLogic, whatever it is, we need to add that plugin to your Eclipse. Understood?
Yes.
Then
Yes.
we can able to get see that option. Then run as server option will get it. So when you run a, when you use run as server, so that internally you already added the Tomcat or else WebLogic, whatever it is, JBoss, then it will deploy into that particular server. But
Exactly.
coming to here, so no need to add it actually. Internally there is a Jetty server is there. Why the people are using Jetty server? It's a lightweight actually. So that is internally already have this AnyPoint Studio. So no need to add any plugin. So we'll directly it will deploy it actually. You are clear? But apart
Okay.
from that, as a development, while developing time, we'll deploy like this, we'll see the output. But if you go environment specific, if you go test or VAT, BAT or production environment, we need a MMC. So then we need to deploy our application into the MMC, runtime server. You are clear?
Okay.
So that's what we are
Yes, sir.
discussing about now. So first we have to download this MMC. Okay. We have to keep it
okay.
Adherence. Then we have to start the server actually. You have
Okay.
to start that server. How will start it? Just click here, startup button.
Okay. Just
okay, so when I click the startup button, it will start it actually. See this internally what this guy did. Internally he is using also this Tomcat only.
Okay.
He's also using Tomcat only.
So now it is starting.
Yes. For that we need to set Java underscore home actually, otherwise it will ask what Java underscore home and all. So if you see this here, they mentioned clearly. So download, so here download button, and they give install instructions
okay.
also. Just go through that instructions. So these are
sure,
download
sure.
button, so just installing instructions they give. So follow these instructions. First we need to set Java underscore home also.
Okay.
Then operating system wise you will give it actually Windows instructions, Linux instructions.
Okay.
Okay. So we need to set the Java underscore home, then we need to like this also you can start it actually. There is a double click on it or else you can start using sh. Once you're done, right? Once you're done, then there is a admin console will open. So ours got started, right? Then trying to open admin console here. Okay, so admin is a password, admin username and password also same. Then click this.
Okay.
This is a GUI actually. This is MMC, Mule Management Console. So here we need to deployment. Okay, now this is a GUI based, total GUI based only. This first we need to add server actually. So according to your requirement, so the first by default it won't there. I only added this dev server actually. Here option will get it actually. So then choose that server, then add that dev server. It will configure internally that server and all. No need to know anything. They will take care. Once you done, this server will come. So now we are in a dev system. They will give some address and all. I don't know. So they will set up it actually. So these are something nothing but single server.
What is the IP address of location you have given?
No, it won't any ask. That's what I'm saying. Just choose the server, give some name. Internally, they will set up one server for you. Understood. Okay.
So this is for every environment.
Yeah, here option is the new server.
Okay.
If you click it, so it will ask server. They will take care, add and all. Give some test environment or something like this. Each environment you can create one server. You are clear? Like
okay.
Add it, so that will come here.
So okay.
This is a single server. You can give a cluster also. You can give cluster means you are clear, you aware it, right? Cluster, multiple nodes are there, multiple servers are there. If you get the request, one server is doing some serving request, it will go whatever the server is in idle, it will go other server that request, right? Clustering concept. So that will also can be, but this is totally free with 1 month only. It's a trial version kind of thing. Generally, we should buy this. Client will take care of these things. So no need to bother about that. Okay. No?
Okay.
So then once you create the server, here a deployment option is there. So click the deployment. Here new option will come. I already deployed my application. So once you export it, right? You are clear. Once you export it, the C drive users. So here it's a coming content based routing GIF file, right? So this one you have to upload it. Upload here. So click new button. Create some name. Create some name and choose server, what server it is, which environment you want. Either it's a dev or it's production, staging, test, development. Accordingly, we choose that. We'll upload that. So wherever you create it, right? We'll upload it. I'll deploy once again. I just undeploy it. I'm deleting. Again, I'm trying to deploy it. Click new button. Then give some name. Content based routing under dev. Okay, now. So next one is choose the server. Mine is dev environment. Click that upload new application. Click browse. This is already a zipped file, right? Already created, exported. Then choose that. Add it. Okay, now that's got it. So then deploy. Okay, so now it's got deployed.
Okay.
So then how you hit the request yesterday? Same way how to hit it.
Okay.
Something like this. Just hit the request accordingly, it will go. Just giving some default, click that.
Okay.
So I didn't start the local actually. That request is coming from where? From the server.
Yes.
Any issues will come here, it will display it actually. Suppose anything is wrong or something, here it will display, as well as we can see admin console also. How we'll see that error? Clear, right? So how we'll see that error if any error is occurred? Suppose while developing local environment, any issues come in console, it will display, right?
Yes.
I'm trying to start it again. What error will get? See. What error will get?
No errors.
See what was the error? Address already bind, address already in use. So we can see in console itself that error. So what was the problem here? So you already used that A0414 here for port number, but again you are using same port number, so that's why it is giving error. Okay, so error you can see in console here, but in environment, so if you get the error, where will say? So here where you are saying under server only, right? This is nothing but a server console, right? You are clear? So come back to here. So choose the servers. In this, this is our server, right? If where you deployed. So I deployed in dev, or else if it is any other server, we have to choose that particular server. Click that dev. So here, whatever the application you deployed, that graph also will come at actually, how the request will come, how it will serve it, all these things it will get it. So here, how much memory it will use, what threads, everything is getting actually. So here, click the files. So here, total application, these total applications will come here. Okay, so here we need to check the logs, right? Click the logs. Here all applications logs will come, not only your application. Understood? How many applications here will deploy? So many people are requesting, hit the request. Accordingly, internally it will generate the log file actually. So how we'll know this? Here we deployed multiple application. How we'll know what was your log, right? So that will decided by you only. So where will decide? Under log4j. Where is that?
Taste.
Yes, somewhere else is there. Resources. Tests in main also should be there. Log 4G. Rest is there. What happened? That got missed or what? Under SRC main resources should be there actually. So here it will decide what was a file it is. We can change it also. We can change it also.
Okay.
By default it will come whatever the name is there, no? Content based routing. Understood?
Yes.
That name will get it actually. Mm-hmm. So accordingly here it will display. Okay, so
okay,
you can click the modified also. What was the recent request will come, that will display on the top actually. Let's see, Mule content is getting lost request. So here you can see the logs, or else we can download it actually. If you see here, we don't see much actually. You can download it, we can open that logs, you can see directly here. Open in somewhere else.
Okay.
See, our request is coming. So hello English. We created one logger, right, in our application. Say lost logger is this, right? The reply. So that log also will come here.
Okay.
Okay. So this is a way to deploy it into the environment actually. And that too, suppose generally here I have not introduced any environment specific actually. In future it will come environment specific actually. Suppose, so here I just hard coded directly, right? So sorry, here I hard coded, right? Like localhost, port number, everything is hard coded. Now clear? So in future how it will come dynamic actually. Whatever this configuration is there now, that will go to the external properties file. We'll create one external properties file under resources. Clear?
Okay.
So that to environment specific actually. Suppose you are in a dev environment, we have to create a dev environment is dev, so dev dot properties will create. Like the test dot properties, production dot properties, some staging dot properties will create it actually. So that time what happened, so here will specific environments, environment specific actually. So there is a mule project.xml is there. So here we'll mention environment specific. So what happened? So suppose if you are in a dev environment, it will pick it up that dev.properties file. Then accordingly, whatever you mentioned that external properties file, that key value pair, it will pick it up, that particular file. Because that port number, that URLs will change from environment to environment, right? Your key.
Yes, yes.
So that's why we have to keep it all these things into environment specific external file. So then your Mule will got to know where you are. So accordingly, it will pick it up that particular environment file.
Okay, okay.
So that will
fetch
it, accordingly it will work. So then that is the way to deploy it, to see the logs. Then if you want to see some files also can see it actually. So here apps is there, no? See total application you can see. This is your application, right? So there's a content-based routing, your classes, whatever classes are there. Your flows you can see, APIs, nothing is there. Nothing is there in the properties file. Like that other things also, properties.
Okay.
Here how it will come, anyway we'll discuss later that one. So here path will decide actually how it will take the dynamic path and all, I mean environment specific. So this is the GUI actually, so we can easily deploy here. You can see request, see this, they will give some graphical view also how the how it will serve it is clear. So how many requests we are getting, how it will serve, so for each minute how many requests we are getting, that type of my graphical representation also, memory related things, so they kept it all these things.
Okay, okay.
There will be dashboard also, so how the memory uses happen. Okay, so that is about this MMC runtime server, Mule Management Console. This has happened exactly. So even we are also using this MMC for deploying and all. So each environment, there is a different MMC is there. So for dev is,
okay.
But we are under cluster environment. This is only single node. This is only single server, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, but we have a cluster actually. That cluster have multiple nodes. Will deploy into multiple multiple nodes actually.
Mm-hmm, okay.
Okay. So as of now, any questions?
Yeah, no questions.
Okay.